Hello everyone, I'm Ritu Chadha. Officially, my full name is Sukhminder. Just to let you know, like a typical Sardarni, I do have a full name, but Ritu is something which everybody's been calling me, and I find that that is something which everyone knows me with much more. I'm a dentist by profession. I've traveled to various countries and I've worked and had a lot of experience. Besides that, I've also wanted to pursue my studies further, and I wanted to do my post-graduation, where at the end of the day, I didn't decide to do an MDS, but I went ahead and did an MBA from IIM. And I also did healthcare and hospital management. I did a post-graduation degree, postgraduate diploma degree from Symbiosis Pune. I kept practicing on these fronts. And at one point, there is a phase where family comes and so does your education and your job comes for forward. And that's the point where I took a little step behind and I did my MBA and moved on. And as I mentioned, I felt that there was much more for me to learn in life. And I went forward to go ahead and learn healing, where I learned divine healing and theta healing. My passion for education is always there, and to learn and to always be there to bring a smile to another person's face is my motto. So that's in brief about me. So today, we're going to talk about a very simple sentence, which I did put up as my topic, is dentistry is not expensive, neglect is. ज़्यादातर हमारे में एक बहुत बड़ी चीज़ है कि हमें थोड़ी सी दर्द होती है, हम कहते हैं चलो इसको सहन कर लेते हैं एंड हम इसको यहीं पे छोड़ देते हैं. बट समटाइम्स इन लाइफ वी डोंट रियलाइज कि वो जो हम निग्लेक्ट करते हैं वो छोटे से बड़े से बड़ा होता जाता है, एंड थिंग्स गेट वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर अस एट अ लेटर स्टेज. एंड इट्स अ वेरी वेरी कॉमन थिंग विच वी सी इन डेंटिस्ट्री, बिकॉज पीपल फील इट्स अ वेरी एक्सपेंसिव प्रोसीजर टू डू. बट आई एम श्योर दैट इफ वी यू नो निप इट ऑफ इन द बड, वी विल एब्सोल्यूटली बी मोर कम्फर्टेबल एंड वील हैव अ ब्यूटिफुल स्माइल, वील वेयर अ ब्यूटिफुल स्माइल एंड वी विल बी ऑफ आर पेन एंड वरीज. So this is what we're going to talk about, and I've made it a very a simple, easy go presentation with a very few basic things covering kind of all age groups. But if you feel that there is something specific, then we can definitely go forward to a specific thing. So I would like to go on to the presentation, and we can have a look. I've just made it a very easy presentation just for you to basically understand and see how we go about with it. So named it in a very simple way, called Dental 101. And this Dental 101 is talking about the presentation where we are going to say the first step. We see a lot of problems which we have seen in general, that dental mein agar hum dekhe kya kya problems hoti hain, commonly which everybody knows is a cavity or is a bad breath, or there is some bleeding gums. These are the most common things which we all face, and we don't realize a lot of times ki hum kis stage mein jaake dentist ke paas jaye ya hum uska kaise apne aap khyal rakh sakte hain. So I'm going to start with the very first basic topic, which is going to be the bad breath, which is a very common thing. And if we say the causes of bad breath, we'll go by very simple things like food, where we talk about onions, garlic, and some volatile, some things which we call as the sulfuric compounds. So there are certain products which leave a smell in our mouth, and we can get that smell very commonly. And onions is a very common thing. I know hum sabko bahut pasand hai pyaaz, aur hum sabko kache pyaaz khane ki bahut aadat hai. But a very simple thing that if we avoid it at a certain time, we will not have an issue with that. Then we also have another issue, is our poor oral hygiene. All of us try to take full care, hum sab brush karte hain, dhyan dete hain, but poor oral hygiene can be because of multiple reasons. It might also be hereditary, you know, because your gums are weak. We've not seen that happening in the families, and pehle itni dental awareness nahi hua karti thi. So if we do take care of our hygiene, we do take care of these things, we will definitely not have a problem of a bad breath. The third thing which is very common, but hamare yahan pe obviously in our group obviously it's not going to be common, is tobacco. tobacco or smoking is one of the reasons where people do not realize, but these people have a very predominant reason of a bad breath. And other reason, the fourth reason, which I don't think a lot of us are going to be aware about, are certain medical conditions which lead to the bad breath. These could be certain respiratory tract infections. There could be certain liver or kidney infections. Or if you have just dehydration, you know, you have a dry mouth, you have that smell in the mouth. So, kai baar hume lagta, oh my God, this is like a big thing. But shayad ye koi medical condition ke karke bhi hamari ye issue ho sakta hai. Now, when we've spoken about all these reasons, we need to know how to take care of these kind of problems which we have because of the breath. So we can have a good breath. Let's talk about food. When we talk about onions or garlic, I think very simple way we can avoid that is ki jab hum subha na khaein, ya agar hume khane ka fir bhi hai, then we definitely do a mouthwash or we brush our teeth so that that smell does not linger on in our mouth. And it would be evident to somebody. Somebody might point it out, somebody might not point it out. But if we can make this a very simple thing by just doing a gargling or by brushing our teeth, we can avoid this. Simple thing, even for any other medical condition, we would say, rinse your mouth with a mouthwash. Or if you're outside and we know we can't carry a mouthwash or something, you can have some chewing gums. You know, like you get the sugarless chewing gums, because if you have the sugarless ones, again, you're not inviting sugar again into your body. And these will help for a better saliva flow in your mouth, which will actually help you to avoid this. Also, we do not realize, but certain times we are snacking and we are snacking on the wrong things. So we tend to get that smell in the mouth, but we can just change our snacks maybe to a good snack like an apple or a celery or maybe eating some carrots, so that these things will not leave that bad smell in our mouth. And of course, having a nutritious diet is always mandatory and helpful, avoiding this kind of a problem. Because agar hamare gums weak honge, hamara diet acha nahi hoga, hamari ye smell ki issue will be one of the first most common indicators for these issues. So we would just in brief know that we can avoid this. It's very easy for us to avoid, and if we can just put in our step on it, that is where we can work things out for it. So another very common thing we can take care of is doing a floss. Most of us do not floss our teeth, and फ्लॉस एक बहुत ही जरूरी चीज है जिससे हम हमारे जो दो दांत है वो इस तरह जुड़े होते हैं. अब ये इसके बीच में जो चीज फंस जाती है, दैट कैन एक्चुअली कम आउट विद अ सिंपल फ्लॉसिंग टेक्निक. एंड अगर हम फ्लॉस करेंगे रेगुलरली, कोई भी खाने का छोटा भी पदार्थ वहां जो रह जाता है वो भी हमें निकालना बहुत आसान लगता है. मोर ओवर इट अवॉइड्स टू जस्ट अवॉइड एनी काइंड ऑफ डिपॉजिट्स टू स्टार्ट हैपनिंग, विच इज एक्चुअली योर फर्स्ट इंडिकेटर लीडिंग टू अदर काइंड ऑफ गम प्रॉब्लम्स. So we spoke about this. Now we're going to talk about the next thing, which is caries or cavities. And I'm sure all of us are very, very predominantly we know about this word called caries, cavity, jo hum kehte hain daant mein keeda lag jana. So ye basically hota kya hai? It's just a breakdown of the heart tissue. So hamare jo daant mein jo bahar ka hissa hota hai, we call it as the enamel. एंड जब हमारे दांत में इनामल में कीड़ा लगता है, तब हमें पता नहीं लगता कि वो कहाँ तक तंग कर रहा है, बिकॉज देर इज नो पेन, देर इज नथिंग विच यू फील, बट स्लोली इट गोज डीप पेनिट्रेटिंग इन. सो बेसिकली इफ वी स्पीक इन द टेक्निकल टर्म्स, वी कॉल इट इज डीमिनरलाइजेशन और ब्रेक डाउन, विच इज कॉज बाय द एसिड्स विच आर प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द बैक्टीरिया विच इज फाउंड इन द माउथ. So when it starts as a small cavity and we call it as a pit. Agar hum uska khyal usi samay jab hame lagta hai, we should actually start taking care of it at that point. But we always feel it only when we start feeling the sensitivity. Aur jab wo sensitivity feel hoti hai, tab tak wo hamare second layer, which is called the dentine, wahan tak pahunch jata hai. And we start feeling the sensitivity, and that is actually the point where whenever it's between the enamel and the dentine, aapko jab lage, you must visit the dentist. and he can fill it up and avoid the thing to go more deeper down so as to have an issue about it. And if we still don't take care about the sensitivity and we keep going on, then it reaches actually the most sensitive portion of the tooth, and which is called the pulp. And that is where when no filling will work for your cavity and we really have to go in for a root canal. And this is where we say that we've neglected something and we've gone in for a more expensive treatment than to go in for a much more cheaper treatment. So when we start feeling that little hole or we see that little black spot, and by brushing or flossing, we've not been able to clean it, I think that is the time, which is like a red signal to say, let's go and go ahead and get this treatment done. So when we have all these problems, we realize that these can actually go down because now it is just not the crown of the tooth, but it is also the root which will get involved when we have the pulp involved. And that means a much more longer procedure, a much more expensive procedure, a much more tedious procedure. And of course, then we need the further thing that we need a crown on that tooth, because of which we might not be able to eat a lot of stuff. Or if it's the front tooth, we cannot bite into an apple or we cannot bite into a carrot. And that causes more discomfort. And hume tab lagta hai ki humne kaash isko ek filling ke saath hi treat kar diya hota, to it would have been much better. When we talk about caries or cavities, we also talk about prevention, which is basically for all of us. And the first thing, as always said, is avoid your sugary foods or drinks. That is the first thing which your bacteria in your mouth feeds on. Again, to avoid the sugary stuff, a very simple thing which everybody says is brush in the night, so that we can make sure we've not left any sugar residue, which is an invitation for the bacteria in the mouth to start the to trigger the problem. Again, flossing is very important because kai bari hum kai cheeze khate hain, as I explained you, a normal sticky thing which could be sugary and gets stuck in between the tooth will not even come out by brushing, and that is where again we need to do flossing. So it's brushing, flossing, and using of mouthwash. All these things are very important for us. Eating disorders, we all have a habit of snacking and impinging on something in the night. Kai bari hum sochte hain that yes, fruits are very healthy and we should snack on that, but no, actually those all have very high sugar content. So if we think of snacking on anything in the night, I think the first thing is either we put a full stop, and if we want to still do it, then we really need to wash or rinse our mouth or brush our teeth before we go to sleep. Because the whole night you are sleeping at peace, but there's somebody else who's enjoying a treat on your tooth then. So you need to decide whether you want him to have a feast or you want your peace in life further on by not going for a treatment. Also, if you have low immunity level, your low immunity level can be because of any kind of ailments, you are very prone to getting caries. Can also be again hereditary. The other thing which is very common is not in Canada, jaise ki jo hum kehte hain, is your fluoride level. So mostly here what you get, the toothpaste and the mouthwashes have a fluoride content. But in a lot of areas in Punjab and other areas in India, there are certain wells jahan pe ye fluoride content pani mein bahut kam hota hai. Here we are really blessed that everything has been monitored and observed by the government authorities, so we don't have to worry about these fluoride content, and we are having the amount which is required. But if we don't have it, we'll very predominantly see little stains like yellowish color stains, which would be seen all over, and this is another thing which leads to caries very commonly. But God bless, we are very lucky and very blessed that we don't have to go through these problems here. We're going to now talk about the bleeding gums or the gingivitis. So one of the biggest bleeding gum causes is the buildup plaque on our teeth. So plaque, if I may just say, is actually a soft sticky film which builds up on the tooth. And this contains millions of bacteria. It's actually like a transparent kind of a covering, which might not be predominantly seen by you. And the only thing is, if again, regular brushing, regular flossing helps you to avoid this kind of problem. But very commonly, pregnancy gingivitis is seen. People who are on blood thinning agents, you will see these kind of ailments much more prone to them. You would see that these people have bleeding in the gums, they have little swelling, and initially they might just not get noticed. And that is why, if you see here, you know, the dentist always recommends you to come to a hygienist and get the cleaning of your teeth done. And why do we need the cleaning? So as to avoid this plaque to form, so as to avoid any kind of deposits to start and lead to problems, which would be an invitation to all your gum problems. How can we decrease this? So brushing, where again, it's morning and night, is very important. Flossing, a couple of times, you know, with age, or sometimes we are not able to put the exact amount of pressure needed. So some people prefer using yeah, sure, Usmaji.
Ritu, I think you have to change the slide.
I'm so sorry. I did not see that. I'm so sorry. Okay, so we finished with the cavities. I'm very sorry on that. So we are on bleeding gums. Can we see that? Mm-hmm. I am very sorry. I didn't see that. So when we do our brushing properly, and if certain times, as I mentioned, certain times when we are putting in the pressure, कई बार हमारे से उतना अच्छी तरह क्लीन नहीं होता या हमारे मसूड़े जब थोड़े दर्द करते हैं, वी आर नॉट एबल टू, आई थिंक रेवा इज नॉट एबल टू सी आवर प्रेजेंटेशन. Are you able to see it now?
No, I can't see it. But anyway, I can listen to you. I think you are explaining well. I can avoid that.
I will put this down on the group after that, so you can just have a look at it. That won't be a problem.
That's fine. Thank you. Please go ahead.
So when sometimes, because jab hamare masoode thode bhi, you know, they are a little swollen or we have a little pain, we tend not to brush properly. And then hamari ek habit ban jati hai ki hum wo pressure utna lagate nahi hai. And those times are the times where actually some people prefer using an electric toothbrush, because of the pressure with what it is being done. It actually enables you to remove the deposits right there. And that's really helpful. So that is why we would really recommend going for a regular visit to the dentist every 3 to 6 months. Having a clean oral hygiene is what enables you to have a good a set of teeth. So let's talk about all the medical conditions where we're talking about. There are a lot of medical conditions. Well, we can talk about diabetes, we can talk about hypertension, we can talk about certain skin disorders, we can talk about any kind of a medical condition. Normal tendency hota hai ki hum sab cheeze apne dentist ko nahi batate hain. But I think it's very important agar hum unhe bataein ki hamare saath, or we have a heart ailment, or we are on blood thinning agents, so that he knows what precautions to take. Kyunki jab hum treatment karte hain, if we have to give you an anesthesia, which they inject sometimes even for deeper scaling or cleaning, then we know whether we want to use that local anesthetic with that particular medication or a different kind of a medicine. But if we are very clear about this to our dentist, it will be very comfortable. So diabetes is one of the most common things which I feel affects the oral health. It causes it to fight. It's a very difficult thing to fight the bacterial infections at that time, because your body's immunity is definitely gone low by now. And this causes an increased amount of deposition of plaque in your mouth, which in turn actually causes a risk for more problems, because this then becomes like thicker deposits. और वो थिकर डिपॉजिट्स आपसे खुद से नहीं निकलेंगे, उसके लिए आपको एक हाइजीनिस्ट के पास जाना पड़ता है. यू विल हैव लाइक सिम्टम्स लाइक लिटिल रेड गम्स, यू विल हैव टेंडर गम्स, यू विल हैव वेरी क्विक ब्लीडिंग. सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स अगेन हैव द प्रॉब्लम. बट इफ आई नो दैट यू हैव डायबिटीज, आई नो दैट आई हैव टू टेक प्रिकॉशंस व्हेन आई एम डूइंग योर स्केलिंग. और आई वुड टेक प्रिकॉशंस कि मेरे को आपको अगर आपका दांत निकालना है या कोई भी ट्रीटमेंट करनी है, आपको एक एंटीबायोटिक कवर के नीचे करनी है. एंड इफ दिस इज देयर, इट जस्ट हेल्प्स द डेंटिस्ट टू नो सर्टन टाइम्स देयर सर्टन स्किन कंडीशंस और देयर सर्टन पैचेस इन द माउथ जो शायद हमारे से भी इग्नोर हो जाते हैं या हमें पता होते हैं, हम सोचते हैं हम नहीं बताएंगे, बट दे वुड गेट नोटिस. सो दीज फ्यू व्हेन आई टॉक अबाउट द स्किन लीजन्स वी डेफिनेटली नीड टू नो, और इफ यू आर अंडरगोइंग एनी काइंड ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट और इफ यू आर अंडर एनी काइंड ऑफ अ मेडिकेशन, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस टू इन्फॉर्म आर डेंटिस्ट अबाउट इट. Again, if you're talking about hypertension, if you've undergone any kind of a surgery, just it is always better to keep things on record than to have any kind of an issue later, which can actually lead you to be landing up into a hospital or landing up into another new complication. So I'm going to cover a little bit on periodontitis also. So जैसे हमने gingivitis बताया था कि हमारे bleeding gums होते हैं, जब वो deposits काफी hard हो जाते हैं, then that leads to periodontitis. वो जो deposits होते हैं, they're like little, when you get your scaling done, they're actually like little flakes which come out, like little stones, you know, and they actually, if they start going in, if this is your tooth and this is your gum, it actually starts moving your gum apart. And that's the invitation for that little bucket which is getting made there with problems. And that, when that happens, then this tooth, which has a complete support of the gum, actually starts moving because now it does not have the support of the gum. So we need to be really, really careful that we take care that these deposits don't go further down. We very commonly neglect these things, especially when we are brushing for the inner side, you know, that portion of the teeth which come on the inner side near the tongue, we tend to not brush that very carefully. And that is where we tend to see these problems more often. I know that a few of us, obviously all of us are much more younger and we are taking care of our teeth. We don't need to think about dentures. But definitely at one point we do think about it. And I do know that some of them would need the denture care. And that is where we are going to talk about the denture care, because if your gums are healthy, we have a good fit and we have the dentures which adapt very easily. So it is very important that we take care of the oral hygiene right from the beginning, right till even after we lose our teeth or we've taken out the teeth for the dentures. Because if we have a good bone support, the denture is going to adapt very well on it. But if this support is lagging a little bit, this one will be also flocking a little bit in the mouth. And so that is one of the reasons where you would actually see that certain dentures just tip off in our mouth, or people while talking, unka denture aage ko aa jata hai. Because of one of the reasons being that the support of the gums or the bone is not enough for them. Generally for the denture care, basically I have seen my own experience where I have just mentioned a few points. Is basically what I've seen is ki logo ko lagta hai ki ab denture lag gaya hai, ye aaj se hi baith jaye aur aaj se hi hame comfortable lagna chahiye. But it is like a foreign body, and if I just make it a little more interesting, aisade jehde nakli dant hunde ne ta jehda sada jabada hunda hai ek nu aur sas da rishta hunda hai. जे जिथे थोड़ी जी नूह चुभेगी उथे थोड़ी जी सस भी चुभेगी, लेकिन जे आप थोड़ी जी चुप चाप उन्हू सहन कर लीएगा तो उथे साड़ी सस भी साड़े नाल खुश रहेगी, तो साड़ी नूह भी साड़े नाल खुश रहेगी. सो जस्ट टू मेक इट ऑन अ लाइटर मोड फॉर द डेंचर्स, इट इज अ लिटल बिट ट्रिकी एंड इट इज अ लिटल बिट टीडियस, बट देर आर सर्टन थिंग्स विच वी नीड टू फॉलो. सो फर्स्टली वेन यू गेट अ डेंचर, इट माइट इम्पिंच ऑन योर माउथ. Which is okay, because that is a foreign body which has come into your mouth and you have to get used to it. If it is really impinging, causing some redness or something, Please, absolutely. You're supposed to go back to the dentist, get that area checked, and get the adjustment done properly so that you can absolutely not have an issue with that. The other thing is mostly सबसे पहले cautiousness ये आ जाती है जब हम denture लगाते हैं कि हमारी speech में फर्क आता है. So जो स्पीच में जब हमारा फर्क आता है उसमें हमें प्रॉब्लम ये आता है कि वी फील कि जो हमारे सामने बैठा है उसको कैसा लग रहा होगा कि अब मैं उस तरह नहीं बोल पा रही हूँ. बट ऑनेस्टली आधे टाइम लोगों को नहीं पता लगता है. उसका एक सिंपल तरीका है, आप एक बुक, एक न्यूज़पेपर लेके आप उसको जोर जोर से पढ़िए, और जब आप वो जोर से पढ़ते हैं स्लोली यू गेट यूज टू दैट एंड यू स्टार्ट स्पीकिंग वेरी कंफर्टेबली एंड यू गेन बैक योर कॉन्फिडेंस. So the biggest problem which we realize is that the confidence goes down. But once all this is set in its place, we really will not have a problem. And after a while, you'll actually feel that this foreign body in our mouth has actually been a blessing to us than being a disgrace. People feel, नहीं, इसको नहीं पहनना चाहिए, इस तरह लगाऊंगी, ऐसा सब ठीक नहीं लगता. But honestly, that actually helps to keep your support in the mouth. That actually helps for it to be retained. Dentures are, again, it can be a partial denture, it can be a complete denture. So you can have both kinds. I mean, but if it's a partial denture or agar hum khyal rakhenge to hamara complete denture jab banta hai usme hame zyadatar problem nahi aati hai. Again, for a denture you need to do regular cleaning. हम जब वो डेंचर निकालते हैं हम उसे पानी में रख देते हैं, वी क्लीन इट विद डेंचर टैब, यू नो, डेंचर क्लेंजिंग टैबलेट्स. बट वी नीड टू मेक श्योर दैट वी क्लीन आर माउथ, वी रिंस आर माउथ, वी कीप अ कंप्लीट गुड ओरल हाइजीन, लेस्ट हैविंग एनी अदर इन्फेक्शंस इन आर बॉडी. बिकॉज व्हेन वी हैव एन इन्फेक्शन इन आर ओरल कैविटी वी कैन डेफिनेटली हैव मच मोर प्रॉब्लम बिटवीन दैट. So I have a question. I'm sorry, I did see a lot of them about the thing about bridge and implants, and I think that's from Meeta. So you can go in for bridges and implants, but we always let that option be with the dentist. You can have a talk at an age where bridges are convenient because आपको निकालना नहीं पड़ता, बारी बारी उठा के पानी में नहीं डालना पड़ता. बट आफ्टर अ टाइम और मे बी जो आपके एडजेसेंट टीथ हैं उसमें इतनी सपोर्ट नहीं हो सकती है, तो हमें उस कंडीशन में वी विल रादर रेकमेंड यू टू गो फॉर अ डेंचर. बिकॉज व्हेन यू आर डूइंग अ ब्रिज यू आर यूजिंग द एडजेसेंट टू टीथ, दे एक्ट लाइक योर ब्रिज एंड द मिसिंग टूथ इज द वन विच वी आर गोइंग टू गिव अ सपोर्ट इन द ब्रिज. बट आपके जो एडजेसेंट दो दांत हैं वो हमें थोड़े छोटे करने पड़ते हैं. सो अगर हमें लगे कि इनकी कंडीशन अच्छी नहीं है, then we will not go in for a denture. We would rather prefer to go in for a denture than to go in for a bridge. Again, implant is something which I know today is the in thing and everybody wants it, but there are a lot of conditions, lot of things which we need to consider. One, we have to have excellent, I wouldn't even say the word good, an excellent oral hygiene to maintain our implants. Secondly, we have to have a good bone strength. We need to have a good bone condition, good oral conditions, like our gums have to be very strong. And if all that is great, we can definitely go in for an implant. But again, with implants, we need to make sure of the medical conditions and what our dentist finally has to say and go for it. So all these things, when we have, when we're talking about a denture or a partial denture, partial might be just one tooth, missing one tooth. It could be two teeth. Certain times it's also cost related. So I'll be very honest about it. Sometimes people, because all these things are going from your pocket. If you feel you are comfortable wearing a partial denture, which is just one tooth, aapke peeche hai, it's fine. But if you feel it's happened at an age of say 25 or 30 years, I would not advise a partial denture. I would rather advise an implant or a bridge, because that is something aesthetically is comfortable and we can go ahead for that at that time. But agar aap bolein ki aap 70-80 saal pe jaake ki, you know, you want to get that one tooth, then we have a lot of things where we need to consider before going for that. And when we talk about a complete denture, we are talking about all the lower and the upper teeth gone, and then we take care of it. But the advantage of wearing a denture, it improves your appearance. आई मीन अगर आप देखें जो लोग बिल्कुल ही डेंचर नहीं पहनते हैं, सो दे हैव अ सैगिंग ऑफ देयर फेस, देयर बोन्स गेट रिजॉर्ब्ड. तो हमें जब बाद में अगर साल दो साल बाद वो सोचे डेंचर लगाना है, वी आर नॉट एबल टू गिव देम दैट परफेक्ट ग्रिप इन द ओरल कैविटी बिकॉज ऑलरेडी वो रिजॉर्प्शन बहुत लेवल तक हो चुकी होती है. विद अ डेंचर वी हैव अ क्लियर स्पीच, वी हैव एन इंक्रीज बूस्ट इन आवर कॉन्फिडेंस. And of course, we can start eating a lot of things of our choice, but we do have certain restrictions because ये तो सिखाओ कि मैं डेंचर लाके हूँ गन्ना भी चूपना है ता फिर थोड़ा जो औखा ही रहूँगा सौखा नहीं रहूँगा. So that's just a little brief of a gist regarding what I wanted to explain you, how to take care. Let's go by brushing properly. Let's go by flossing our teeth. Let's go by rinsing our mouth. Let's go by keeping our smiles upright, and let's go by visiting a dentist once in a while. Thank you so much.